Hey, hope everyone's having a great weekend. I am finally getting the hang of this online thing. I have to give a special shout out to Patrick, who I inboxed several times with some silly questions, but very, very helpful professor. Thank you for your grace helping me out with all of this. So, Vid Journal number 2, week 2. I want to be very transparent here. Last week, I was a bit discouraged. I read and learned some things that kind of put me in a place of like, how can I help? Am I fighting a battle that's already destined to be lost? And is the rest of my life going to be encapsulated by this emotion of just despondence and discouragement? So I prayed and God was super faithful, because this week's assignment, as I read through the chapters, as I'm just doing a little more studying and learning more, I am starting to see glimmers of hope, and God's kind of speaking to me of certain areas where I can get involved in that I can be a help. One of the things that really popped out to me, and something that I was very ignorant of, was the designs of jails. I had an idea of what they looked like. I had visited one in the past years ago. Probably like 10 years ago, I did a tour the first time, my first round of college when I was receiving my associates. And I now remember it was courtyard style. But now reading all these different designs and different models and just seeing the limited interaction that inmates have with staff, hearing more about the just privately owned jails. I didn't know too much about them. For the first time ever, I heard of the concept of regional jails and realignment processes and policies that are just creating more opportunities for release of inmates in jails. And what I really realized is that the entry way, as they call it in the book, which is jails, right before going into prison, if that's where someone's headed, there's very, very little treatment happening there. The turnover is extremely high. Staff are underpaid. That leads to low morale. The mentally ill are not being served well. So I just started to think about, honestly, a week ago, this would have discouraged me, but I got excited to see, wow, this is a huge problem. The lack of reentry programs that are starting with someone being in jail. So I just, I'm excited to see these numbers and see the stats. And I'll be honest with you, I think a little shift of attitude and perspective really, really helped. Learning just even the jargon and the language of everything that's in these books. I mean, you're definitely seeing a different Ruth from last week. And I've just been asking the Lord, like, God, where do I fit in this? Should I have just done biblical studies and not touch criminal justice? But this week's assignments, this is going to sound bizarre, but they sparked a lot more questions for me than answers. But I know that these are questions that will lead me in the right direction. So I feel like I'm failing and stumbling forward through these assignments, and I'm learning a lot, but I'm slowly starting to see where I fit in. And I think I'm starting to get a passion for discipling women that are being released from jail and just helping them re-enter the community. And I'd love to start that process while they're there and continue it even when they're released. So I don't know what that looks like, have no idea. And I'm pretty sure as I continue taking these courses, I'll learn more about policies and opportunities. I'll meet people that will help me. But yeah, I'm super excited about growing, and that's how I've grown this week. A little shift perspective. I learned more, and I feel like I'm still lost in the right direction. So doing well. Thank you all. Love you all in Christ, and have a great Sunday evening.